So we were asked to provide our thoughts about some of these tinnitus cures that we see online, and we know that many of these won't be a definitive cure for tinnitus, but there are a lot of videos out there that could be of help, and there are definitely some videos with a lot of positive feedback, so we just wanted to check out a few of these. Let's play this one.
I put them over my ear, and then I...
Yeah, he's doing this, okay.
Yeah, and his hands are covering his ears there.
Well, I think he's massaging his neck.
Yeah, I think that's part of it. I mean, the posterior neck muscles.
Yeah.
There's some thought that the posterior neck muscles, as well as neck musculature and jaw muscles in general, can affect tinnitus, or in some cases make tinnitus worse, and in some cases make tinnitus better.
Yeah, I found that in my experience that, neck tension, shoulder tension, anybody who has those kind of problems, if you can relax those muscles, many times the tinnitus won't necessarily go away, but it can get better.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that could be the case in these patients for whom this technique is working. And that's not going to be all patients, of course, but certainly some patients will have some benefit from this. So this video is talking about pulling on the pinna, which is the external ear, this part here, to help alleviate the tinnitus. And she describes various techniques on what direction you can pull it and how hard to pull it.
Boy, I don't know. It looks painful.
It does a little bit, actually. I can see it helping. I mean, I think anything that alters perhaps a patient's sensation around that area can have some potential benefits to auditory sensation. It could go along with the muscle tension thing that you're talking about, because pulling on the pinna is certainly going to a certain degree, stretch the skin and the muscles in the surrounding area.
Well, I find patients, even just like they just push on their masseter muscle here, will get a change in their tinnitus.
For sure.
So it's amazing the amount of central feedback that goes on in the brain that can amplify the tinnitus or can reduce the tinnitus. Are these people selling these things or just...
I'm not sure. This exercise does look very aggressive. I think, along the same lines, we're talking about muscle tension and neck tension. I think it might be acceptable if it's in a supervised setting, as it seems like this video is demonstrating.
Well, I think some people find just massage helps, but again, it's just trying to relax the muscles. If they have some issues with their neck, reducing that, it may help.
Yeah, and even just simple massage. I mean, it doesn't have to be a fancy massage. Even very simple massages that either somebody who's close to you can do for you, even that can be very effective.
And of course, relaxation. It's the key.
Yeah. So this video talks about sound therapy for tinnitus. Sound therapy, I think, is a tried and true technique to help alleviate tinnitus. I would say that only a minority of my patients go through with, investing the time and perhaps the money to try sound therapy, but there are definitely many resources that are free of charge available. And this video seems to talk about some of those techniques and, some of those sounds that can potentially help.
Well, again, I think you're putting in a sound from the external, which helps to make you less aware of the tinnitus, but also with repeated exposures to this type of sound, many times the patient's tinnitus kind of fades into the background.
Right.
They don't no longer pay attention to it.
Yeah, so I think it's a combination of desensitization,
right,
as well as simply masking. So listening to some other sound and taking one's mind off of the tinnitus.
Masking is always important. Like, it can be very helpful at night. People that have trouble sleeping when it's very quiet,
absolutely,
the tinnitus becomes much more obvious.
So I think this is something that I would actually highly recommend patients at least give a shot.
Yeah. Oh, for Pete's sakes. I hope you don't send your patients for this. So I want to see you demonstrating this to patients in the office.
It's possible. I mean, I think going back to the thought that changing the sensation around that area can lead certain patients to get some relief, and maybe it won't work for other patients, but I mean...
Well, I think part of it's relaxation. I think this is like a massage, trying to relax the muscles.
Yeah, and it's taking your mind off of everything else. You're sort of focusing on just your motions. I think there's a lot to that. There's so many factors that go into tinnitus, and anxiety and stress is a huge thing, and if there's anything that we can do to relax.
Muscle tension, because this is like what he's doing is he's working in this area where we expect to see a tension headache. Mm-hmm. You can reduce the tension. Now he's
pressing
on the temporal mandibular joint. Here is the joint. Yeah. Some patients with temporal mandibular joint issues will have tinnitus.
Yeah, absolutely.
And trying to massage that area may be helpful. And again, over the temporal areas where the tension builds up and back in the back of the neck. In my experience, anything you can do to relax muscles will help, but tinnitus is something that it may not go away, but we want to try to make it better. That's why, biofeedback, I'll mention that. I don't know if you refer patients to that.
Sure.
That can be very helpful in the proper therapist's hands, teaching patients to relax certain muscles and stimulate blood flow and neurofeedback, which is brainwave alterations.
Sure.
Patients can be put into a state of relaxation, which will help.
Yeah, I completely agree with that. And there are a couple of practitioners in Los Angeles who are good at that, and we send patients out their way. And I think the first is, make sure you see a doctor and get your hearing checked out, an audiologist or an otologist or neurotologist like us. And the second is that for the vast majority of tinnitus cases, it's nothing to worry about. It's not the sign that there's anything seriously wrong with the ears or the brain. It's something that the patient might need to work through, but it's not the sign of anything bad.
The point is that they need an evaluation, because tinnitus is a symptom. So they here at the House Clinic in Los Angeles, we see quite a few tinnitus patients, and we take a history, do a physical examination, have a complete audiometric evaluation, and sometimes additional tests are ordered if indicated.
Right.
So I think that's an important thing to keep in mind.
Sure.
Hi, I'm Erin, Associate Director of Education and Global Hearing Health here at the House Institute Foundation. Thank you for watching our video. If you would like to support research, education, or global humanitarian efforts, please consider donating by clicking the link in the description box below. Be sure to check out our other videos, like, subscribe, and click the notification bell so you can get notified anytime we post. Thanks.